Hey everybody, Ms. Dietrich. We're going to take a look at a question that in the past has caused some problems for some students, so we'll work through it together using a tape diagram. A plane is flying from Albuquerque, New Mexico to Austin, Texas. So far, it has flown 161 miles or 23% of the total distance of the flight. How far is the flight from Albuquerque to Austin? So we're talking about a flight from Albuquerque all the way to Austin. And if we make the entire trip, that's 100% of the trip. So let's put that over here. Now what we're trying to figure out is how many miles is that? This whole bar will represent how many miles? Now here's what we know. We know that about 23% of it, so if we show 23% on this and make it somewhat proportional, it's a little bit less than a quarter of it. 23% is how much they've gone so far, and that's 161 miles. We need to know the total distance. How many miles altogether is it from one distance, one city to the other city? So we have a couple ways that we can do this. One way is to think about what we know about parts and wholes. Now we've only gone a little bit of the ways. That's 23 out of 100. 23% is 23 out of 100. And this 161 miles is not the entire trip. That's what we're trying to figure out. We're trying to figure out the whole trip. So let's put a W and we'll put this number in for the part. All right, so once you get to this point, you want to look to see if this can be simplified. It can't. When that happens, then you proceed with cross products. All right, so this cross product going this way would be 161 times 100, which would be this. The other cross product going this way would be 23 times W. All right, so once we have an equation that looks like this, the opposite of multiplying a variable times 23 is to divide it by 23. This will cancel out. We'll bring down the W. The only thing you have left to do is to take this blue number, which is 16,100, and divide it by this number. Now you want to look at your choices here so you know what to start with, because we have to find our multiples of 23. They're suggesting either a 7, a 5, a 3, or a 1 to start off. So if, let's say you have no idea what to start off, then just try choice A. Try 23 times 7 and see what you get. And then you'll pick it up from there. Now if that ends up being the right answer, then just keep going to make sure that 23 goes into this number 700 times, and if it does, then you found your answer. If not, then go on to the next choice or just finish the long division. Good luck finishing this up.